Please see the accompanying PDF for additional resources and materials. Simon & Schuster Audio presents Do Better, Spiritual Activism for Fighting and Healing from White Supremacy by Rachel Ricketts, read by the author.
This is for my mother, Suzette, and Uncle Carlton, for my ancestors who so often went unheard, with hearts unhealed, and for every Black girl who has ever felt they didn't belong. May we all find freedom. Introduction. My love includes anger. What I hope to do all the time is to be so completely myself that my audiences and even people who meet me are confronted with what I am inside and out, as honest as I can be. And this way, they have to see things about themselves. Nina Simone. We are living in entirely uncertain times. Our politics are increasingly divided with no reassuring route for recourse. As I write this, the world is in a standstill to combat the worst global pandemic since 1918. Cities are on fire in all 50 states, and folks of all races have taken to the streets around the globe in an uprising led by Black folks in the quest for Black and thus collective liberation. The systems of inequity that have persisted and been protected for centuries are being exacerbated, and the stillness forced by global quarantine has meant many are no longer able to turn away. White people have finally awakened to white supremacy and anti-Blackness in a way they refused to before. The things many of you were privileged enough to once take for granted are slipping from your fingers, and shit is scary. Our personal and collective grief is palpable. Things are and will continue to be chaotic, and increasingly so. But amidst all this chaos and uncertainty is an opportunity. The oppressive systems and institutions as we once knew them are slowly beginning to crumble. Everything is being burned to the ground so that we as a collective can rise renewed. We are being summoned to the inner spiritual work that revolution requires. Some are calling it the end of everything that never worked right in the first place. And it is. Though these systems were created to work exactly as designed, because they benefit their creators, those with the most power and privilege. To overthrow them, we must all take a long look in the mirror to deal with the hard shit. And this is a book all about the hard shit. White supremacy, heteropatriarchy, grief, oppression, and more. This is also a book about my interactions with the hard shit. I write what I know best, which is my experience, both personal and professional, in equal measure. My name is Rachel Ricketts, hey, and my pronouns are she, her, hers. I am a Black, queer, cisgender, non-disabled, neurotypical, Canadian-born woman with ancestors of West African, Jamaican, Indian, Jewish, Portuguese, Western European, and Taino descent. I grew up Black and financially insecure in mostly white and wealthy spaces, and have spent a lifetime navigating intersecting systems of oppression. Though I am a trained racial justice educator, attorney, grief coach, and spiritual activist by profession, this work is personal. Because the most grief I have ever endured and will continue to is at the hands of white supremacy. This grief has rooted within me an overflowing reservoir of love and gratitude, as well as an unwavering fire of righteous rage, deep inside my bones and belly. Love and anger. With good damn reason. White supremacy murdered my mother. It was after my mother's death that I rededicated my life to the work of fighting racial injustice, in her honor and mine. Though I was born with my third eye open, my deep connection to spirit intensified after helping my mother die, equipping me with the tools to help heal my heart and hold space for others to do the same. It led me to create my spiritual activism workshops, potent racial justice seminars that fuse spiritual-based soul care with embodied anti-racism education, so that we can learn to tolerate the challenging emotions that arise when we address oppression. This book is an extension of my workshops, blending my lifetime of personal experience navigating white supremacy with my soulful anti-racist teachings to create an accessible and relatable guide for all those ready to fight for a more equitable world in which everyone, most notably Black and Indigenous Women Plus, can finally find freedom. White supremacy harms us all. White supremacy is the status quo. It causes one of the greatest forms of systemic social trauma on the planet, inciting grief, guilt, loss, pain, anger, and shame for everyone. Racism mires Black, Indigenous, and people of color in emotional and physical violence, and, in order to perpetuate the oppression of others deemed less than, it robs white folks of inner peace and meaningful connection to themselves and others. For my fellow folks of the global majority, including the mixed race folks and especially my fellow Black and Indigenous women plus, addressing our internalized oppression is where we most get stuck. We've endured centuries of institutionalized discrimination, of shittier housing, education, pay, job opportunities, healthcare, access to justice, etc., not to mention slavery, dehumanization, intergenerational trauma, emotional violence, and constant reminders that we're less than because we don't belong to whiteness. We keep quiet and code switch in order to keep white people comfortable at the expense of our own well-being. Our anti-racist work is unplugging from whiteness and reclaiming our power. For my white or white-passing friends, internalizing dominance and privilege results in a disconnection between head and heart. White supremacy requires you to cut yourself off from meaningful connection with yourself and others. The most pertinent thing you all can do to dismantle racist systems is first address your own personal racism, not just the racism out there. The ways you inherently perpetuate white supremacy and the grief, loss, pain, and trauma that are creating obstacles for you to authentically do so. No small feat, because as we'll learn, when you start to become truthfully aware of who you are and the harms you've caused, your world turns upside down. For mixed Black, Indigenous, and people of color with white ancestry, you will likely find that your work is to address both your internalized oppression as well as your internalized dominance. No matter your race, ethnicity, or mixture, racial justice begins with a sobering soak in your own reflection and all that lies beneath. To awaken to the ways in which white supremacy is playing out in your day-to-day, the ways you contribute to its prevalence, and the hurt it is causing us all. Here's the tea. Racial justice starts with you, and it starts within. There can be no genuine outer shift unless we get right with ourselves first. And racial justice requires a major collective upheaval. It necessitates an overhaul of every system we have ever known the world over. This is why I need you to tap into your heart space, connect to your righteous rage, and use it as fuel for systemic and collective change. I wrote this for every human ready, able, and willing to do the hard, vital, and urgent inner work required to dismantle white supremacy. So let me be clear. This ain't no cakewalk. Real talk. Learning about white supremacy and doing anti-racist work is work. This is not for those wishing to merely dip their toe. Oh no. Unpacking racism, oppression, and their impact is often triggering on a mental, spiritual, emotional, and at times physical level. Many elements of my story and teachings may flare up painful memories or traumas of your own. I cried a lot of tears writing this, and you are likely to shed tears listening to it. Diving in takes courage, bravery, and resilience. You must acclimate your body to better withstand your discomfort and shower yourself in compassion, so you have a hope in hell of bestowing that same compassion on others, particularly Black and Indigenous women plus. When we come together to face oppression, we unearth potent personal and collective trauma. Moving through this book will be no different. It will expose your hurt, but my wish is that it will also inspire your hope. I'm here to help you through, and I do so from a space of deep love for us all. Still, make no mistake, this is not a fluffy, love will change the world manifesto. Love can change the world, but it is not a send light and prayers kind of love. The love needed to create radical racial justice includes daily, intentional, and informed action on a global scale. It includes owning up to the emotional violence we have perpetuated on ourselves and others, both as individuals and as part of the collective, and most notably toward Black and Indigenous women plus. It is a love embodied by truth and integrity. It runs the full spectrum of human emotions, including anger. Righteous rage has been a vital component in efforts to do better, past and present. The collective shift racial justice demands requires the same fervor. I believe love and righteous anger are the precursors to the critical shift we desperately need to manifest in the world today, to doing better. Some call me the general of loving anger. You'll soon find out why. I share my stories not to condemn the mistakes of others, but to illuminate the ways we cause each other harm, often to those most oppressed. Harms that I too have inflicted as a perfectly imperfect person and oppressed oppressor. In these pages, you will find carefully curated exercises to get into your body and enable you to better withstand the discomfort that inevitably arises as you partake in racial justice. I believe getting more comfortable with our discomfort first is the gateway to our collective salvation, to racial and social justice. It starts with compassionately connecting to yourself and filling up your soul so you can truly do the work and commit to collective change. A car can't drive on empty, am I right? Every chapter ends with a spiritual offering to tend to your soul and/or a tangible call to action to support you in tending to your heart and better holding space for yourself and the collective, all while prioritizing the most marginalized. From guided meditations and breathwork to reflection and visual exercises, you'll be armed with spiritual tools I've used time and time again to support folks face their fears, confront challenges, and heal racial wounds. All of which is done in a culturally informed way, honoring the roots of the practices and communities of color that cultivated them. Mindfulness and breathwork will serve as the pillars for returning to ourselves, navigating our discomfort, and actively doing better. Part one takes you on a deep dive within to understand and address oppression at the inner level. And in part two, I share more of my story enduring white supremacy and guidance for taking much-needed outer action. My goal is for you to finish the book feeling enlightened, empowered, and ready to act. We need you, especially the white folks, because y'all are late. Written to, not for. Though this book is meant to inspire healing and change for all humans, this book is directed primarily to, though not for, white women plus. I did not want to write a book to white women plus, truly. But white women plus have caused me the most racial harm, so I feel compelled to address my first book to them directly, especially cis women. Still, this book is for everybody. Everybody. I write for Black and Indigenous women plus first and foremost. Every facet of my work is for us and our healing. This book is written to white women plus, but it is for us, our well-being, our humanity, and our liberation. We are at a pivotal crossroads as a collective, one that has not been experienced since the civil rights movement of the 1960s. This is a global uprising. How we choose to harness the energy of the day, or not, will have lasting consequences on folks.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.